but back out here again. It's getting to be a bit like Groundhog Day. Originally we had a leak on one of these capillaries, which we've replaced. And a few months later we had a leak on the roast lock, which we put a new gasket in there and thread locked it. And I've also put some yellow paint on there so I can see if it come undone again. And we're back out here again, because it's got no gas in it again. We've put some nitrogen in it and gone around with a leak detector. So it's just pressurised what was left in there. We're picking up something on the fusible plug, and it does look a bit. There we go. It does look a bit oily, so put some leak spray around it and see. It's tricky to work on, isn't it? It's in a little cupboard between the machine here and here, and I can just about fit in between the pump, stainless side, and the wall. Yeah.
I didn't think it was leaking until I've looked around the side. It's absolutely pouring out of there. There's a load of little bubbles, I think, as well. So I have to
take it out and reseal it. I've got that. It's lost 1.2 psi in 16 minutes. We've got the valves on the receiver and the suction shut off, so that leakage is just on the unit. If it hadn't dropped on the unit, then I'd have opened them back up. And then if it had dropped, I'd have known it was in the pipework or in the cooling coil in there, on the valve or something like that. I've got my blanking plug out and clean the threads up. They look okay. We've just got to clean the threads up in the receiver and then put some more sealant on there. I'm not sure what to go with. That's what I used the last time, which has been pretty good. In fact, it's the first time I've seen this stuff fail. But could have been sort of, I don't know how long ago I sealed it up. Could have been 5 or 6 years ago, maybe a bit longer. So I've got this stuff, Loctite, which is supposed to be very good. Bubbles now and again. Liquid going in. About 2 degrees. Well, bottom pressure was about 60 psi, about 2 degrees. I seem to remember it's about 3.5-4 kilos. So we're getting there. I've dumped a bit more in before I run it, but. Pressure's equalised before I got, well, I got about 2 of the big kilos in. Running now. This is the one next to it. That's a replacement compressor. One valve, some on a bit of pipe. The original ones like this, but they've discontinued that. this one's a CRJQ300TFB551. And you can see there, sidebars have started weeping on it. You can see the oil staining. So we need to get a sightglass kit ordered up for this and get that changed and some fresh oil in there in the near future. It doesn't look too bad because it's just a bit wet, but it's only going to get worse. That's what killed the other one. The sightglass leaked all the oil out and did the bearings in, so yeah. It's nearly 20 years old, so. They do, I've noticed with these things, once they're sort of 10 or 15 years old, the O-rings seem to go on and they start leaking, so it's worth checking these.